Well, we still have a second four before the really fast laps come in. I show the viewers the current standings in the Drivers' Championship. So, what is important for this race? It's today leading by only 17 points over Fisifan. So, he wants to maintain his first position, obviously, in the standings to get the championship, as this is the final race. But only 17 points, so that would be an exciting battle between Fisi and today there.
Absolutely, and the way that those two have been fighting it out, I mean, goodness me, the amount of pressure that Fisi was put under by Manu and vice versa at Hockenheim was just unreal.
And if you see the drivers' ranking, you see today had a DNF in the first race, and Fisifan had a disqualify in the race at Catalunya and the feature,
which he'd already retired from. That was a little bit insult to injury, because he'd already retired from the race, and then he was deemed to have been disqualified from it, which I think is a little bit unfair. But
yeah, but it doesn't make a difference. So
no, it didn't on that particular occasion.
However, in all other races, both drivers always scored fifth or better, and in most cases, even podiums from both drivers.
So Manu, unsurprisingly, is at the top of the time sheets with a 1:57.645. His teammate Flying Cameo was briefly second, but it's just been usurped by AJ. Oh, excuse me. Gibbs has got a flying lap in. Hopefully Gibbs will be able to actually get to the finish line. He did manage to do so in Hockenheim. He's had such horrific luck. And I was also able to commentate on the first round of Season 5 of the GT3 Pro League, of which Gibbs is in. And his bad luck struck again, would you believe? He was right up the front for a period of time, and I think he spun and finished 7th in that particular occasion. Now, Fizzy's just taken the pole lap, pole time, 1:56.748. Already, these two mammoths are going at it. I'm having a bit of trouble with my sound here as well. Isn't helping me.
I still have some other facts. Fizzy and today share the most pole positions this season. Three pole positions each. But today got 7 race wins, where Fizzy only got 3 race wins. However, the fastest laps is Fizzy's thing again, with 4 fastest laps, and today only 3.
So that just shows you how close it has been.
It is. You're right. And it also shows that Fizzy is usually better in qualifying and pure pace. However, today shows his excellence in the races with the fights and the race starts, where Fizzy had some problems in the past, yeah.
Certainly early on, but his starts in the last 3 races have been absolutely unbelievable. Just watch Manu come over the line. Hasn't improved in second. He's still at 1:57.394. I think he improved his time, but not his position, though. Fizzy now. I should know my corner names, but I'm afraid I don't. I think he's just coming down to the chicane. Yes, he is. He's just coming down to the chicane, turns 19 and 20. And he spins! Well, that's the end of
that attempt. Yeah.
He's just about got time. He has just about got time to get another lap going.
Yep.
Now, I've done it again. I've left my driver line on. And, I'm too late to fix that now. Never mind. Down the old start-finish straight he goes.
So, well, actually today is on a very fast lap now, I think. Currently exiting the second sector, where his sector times seem to be really, really fast. So we might see an improvement in this lap.
So Manu's coming through Blanchimont now. There's turn 18. Down towards the chicane.
AJ also on a very fast lap. He's really strong here at Spa.
He had a great showing, 5th and 4th, I believe, last time out. But does awesome. Manu improve?
After the bad luck he had in the beginning of the season, that's really nice to hear.
I think it's this finish line they use, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah.
Today will.
Oh, Manu is not improved. Well, he's improved in time, but again, this pole that goes to Fizzy, it seems.
Very, very close. Where's Govankini, by the way? He was very fast in a practice, but...
Govankini, that's Govac, is it not?
He's on 11 at the moment. Well, that's
unusual. Govac joined the season very, very late and proven to be very on the pace since joining, but not getting to grips with what we see here. Pedro is in third place. He's in the pits. He's not going to improve. AJ, where is he? He is. That looks early on the lap, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's coming down
to finish.
He's not really from there.
Interesting.
Berkman. Oh, it's right at the beginning of the lap, isn't it? Yeah, there's nowhere near it. With 30 seconds left to go, K-Man in the pits, worn tire in the pits, Paradiski. And again, is ready to be near the beginning of the lap. Yeah, that's just come through turn 11.
I'm kind of sure that Keeney had problems with the track limits, because again, this lap he's on, there are no sector times, so he probably was disqualified from the system there for this lap.
That would explain his starting position. But here we go then. That is the time up. So your feature race, your final feature race of this series is Fizzy, Manu, Pedro, AJ, Stokeman, Flying K-Man, Warm Tire, Paradiski, Gibbs, and Mr. DBZ Leica. Excellent effort by you, gentlemen. So then, into the five-minute practice session, which I have occasionally come out to...
Which is 10 minutes.
I think AJ is the host, so he's got that one wrong. Oops.
It's not wrong. I think in the forum someone
Was requested,
said because
wasn't
of problems.
It was, I think, because the track is longer. It was actually requested to be 10 minutes. Indeed, very well spotted, Mr. Tony. Gives me slightly longer to eat my food. Who's out on? So who else have we got? We have Seri, we have El Nano. Mr. Alcon, who didn't really see at all. Who else have we got that I haven't mentioned so far? Govankini, which is otherwise known as Govac. I'm pretty sure that's right. Correct me if I'm wrong, Mr. Tony.
Oh, I guess it's right.
I'm sure Govankini is his forum name. We have Mr. Soprano. I didn't see him at all during the qualifying run. We have Franco Droz. Didn't mention him, and that is everybody. So we have 16 runners for the final feature race. Who is out on track? Let's have a look. Have we got any runners? We have a few runners. Considering it was it's requested to be an extended practice session, I'm surprised not more cars are out. But we have El Nano currently on circuit, along with Mr. Alcom. I'm getting some horrible jittering around at the moment.
Govan just did a little start test there, a launch test, probably to adjust his clutch, like in Formula 1.
Watching Mr. Alcon go through Puan. Long turn 12. I'm just going to pause my stream for a second. I'm trying to get myself a decent map that I can refer to. Yep, that one looks good. Except for the fact that that one's also got the start line in the wrong place. Try that one.
Yeah, I'd rather have the Formula 1 version of the start line and the crit in Project Cars. Because it provides more exciting starts going into La Source and as the first turn of the circuit.
There we go. I'm going to get a map here, so apologies for those looking at my stream, because it will have currently stopped. There we go, it should be underway again. El Nano just coming to the end of his lap. And 7 minutes then of this practice session. So, what have you been up to then since we last spoke, Mr. Tony?
Well, I had some stuff to do, writing some exams in the university and gathering stuff for my new flat, so not much time for actually streaming and doing stuff.
But you did take part in the first GT3 race of Season 5, didn't you?
Since last week, I'm more free and the time again, and I will also stream the GT3 race on Wednesday.
Which, and you have Fizzy and Yorkie, I believe, commentating for the Elite category, which you are in.
I will swap positions with Fizzy, and he can talk about me and not me about him.
I solo commentate the Pro League, and tell you what, last week's race was fascinating. It was actually great to see. Yeah, someone's clouted into the wall, and so my camera's on El Nano, and someone just banged into the wall.
Yeah, I rewatched your stream in parts, and everyone today in the chat, I can only recommend you to go to RangerCarrot's channel and watch his commentating of the Pro League.
But indeed, anybody on my side, please do go and check out Tony R's videos. So it's Tony R 600 on Twitch. Is it the same on YouTube?
On YouTube, it's just Tony's Racing. You will find it with that.
And it's just RangerCarrot for me. There's no space, no hyphens, or anything like that. Do find me. That's why I'm juttering a lot. My stream is actually running. I don't need that. Don't need my bandwidth vanishing. So yes, I do apologize for the fact that I'm munching. It's not something I would normally make a habit of, but I was so late getting on stream this evening, I hadn't had time to devour.
I guess our viewers understand that.
And I'm quite a big lad, so I need my foods. So then, less than 4.5 minutes to go then. The practice session. Now that I've sorted out my jittery problems, it's much more smooth. Less things taking up my bandwidth.
So Alex Salmon asks how many points you get for a win. That would be 25 points
for the feature race.
Yeah. I don't know, for the sprint race, it's
10, I think? I'm not sure either. I can't remember either.
15, actually. 15.
15. Beg your pardon.
So, yeah, we have 25 and 15. 25 and 15. And second place gets 20 points. Third place, 17 points. So, the advantage of 17 points for today will be still there if he finishes sixth place in the feature race.
So he has to finish higher than 6th in the feature race to become champion.
Yes. I think 6th should already
be enough. He has to score 2 more than Fizzy. At least 2 more than Fizzy in the feature race to become champion. We have a bit of crashing going on here on the old start finish line, I can see. El Nano, I don't know who he's clunked into. Pedro RC99, our race winner from last week. Multiple race winner from last week, indeed. Where is he? He's about halfway through the lap. Oops, I haven't got my map. Again, stopping my stream. Again, apologies for who is watching me. Here we go. I will get better at this streaming lark, I promise. More practice at it I get, but I would have liked more preparation time than I was able to do, but sadly it wasn't to happen.
So as I said earlier, we will have 15 laps in the feature race and only 8 laps in the sprint race. So this will be really, really exciting. Only 8 laps. Mm. If you see the overtaking opportunities, especially with those cars, you might only have 8 overtaking opportunities in this sprint race then.
Mm,
one per lap.
Mm-hmm.
As on the long straights, as we know from Monza, it's not really possible to overtake because those cars are limited by their gearbox, so you can't really have a top speed advantage on the long straights.
Being that all cars have the exact same setups, we are all drivers are forced to the default setup. There are no differences between each driver.
So,
I'm just watching Pedro come down the camel straight down to Le Com.
Just wanted to say some guys still use it for practicing purposes, the 10 minutes here.
Just over a minute to go then.
Pedro being one of them, already on his third lap around this little warm-up session.
Indeed he is. And through pull one then for Pedro.
Only 30 seconds.
30 seconds indeed. Now I do apologize in advance, I will be coughing a little bit, as well as munching. I actually have ulcers at the back of my throat, which is going to make talking today rather interesting. But the show must go on, as the old phrase goes. Well, Pedro's decided to put it in the pits. Well, just Mr. Alcon, I think, running around. Oh, we have less than 10 seconds to go anyway.
I really, really hope and I cross my fingers that the start goes right for everyone, because there is not much room on the starting grid here in Spa. You can't really overtake on the grid. Well, you can't do anything, really, so it will be really exciting.
Absolutely. So here we go then with Manu. It looks like Manu's on pole from my perspective, but that was should have been Fizzy.
From my perspective, it's Fizzy, so it should be.
Okay, so 3, 2, 1, wind them up and let them go. Oh no, I think I'm. Didn't get out of someone's way in time. Someone actually nudged me before I managed to get out of the way. Manu has taken the lead then. Manu has jumped.
Oh, and the crash in the back.
Oh no, that I hope that really wasn't my fault.
That was one tire. No, it was in Eau Rouge.
Oh no, I see there's more bother going on in the back. I'm watching the front battle at the moment with Fizzy, Manu, Pedro and AJ. Currently, Manu has got the lead. Oh, AJ's got the inside there at turn 5. And Fizzy just managing to keep hold of second place. AJ right there. And Pedro trying to force his way through on the inside.
Wow.
But for some reason, Pedro's showing he's in 5th for some reason. And wow. We must have retirees already.
Yeah, the problem is...
showing us as being in the front. Because Fizzy's Manu's listed as 3rd. Who else? Govac and Seri have retired already from this race. Manu already getting a bit of a lead for himself as he comes through turns 12 and 13. Goodness me, did Manu need to get a good start then?
So awesome, the first few corners, many fights here. Fizzy probably didn't start very well, but might have been in the Eau Rouge actually where today could overtake him. I couldn't see it in time, but.
No, unfortunately, I was very, very slow getting into my spectator position, unfortunately. But Fizzy's having to fend off Pedro already as they come down to the bus stop chicane. Manu having a slim lead, about a second or so. Oh. It looks like Flying K-Man going into a bit of a tangle there in about 6th or so. Just jump back. Gibbs is holding his position. And here we go, the positions are now sorting themselves. Oh, Mr. Soprano's in the pits as well. He's retired from this race already. Goodness me. Jump back up to the front end. Manu's now stretching his legs at the front as they enter into lap 2 with Fizzy beginning to break away slightly from Pedro. But there, just one simple mistake is all it will take for these positions to change very, very quickly. onto the Camel Strike then for the lead half dozen or so. Pedro having a look, he's going to have topped out before they get to Le Combe.
That's correct. But Fizi also went into defensive mode, so I think an overtake would have been very, very hard to pull off for AJ.
Absolutely. For Pedro. For Pedro, yeah. So AJ watching on in fourth position. He had a really strong showing on last week at Hockenheim. And Manu's not getting a great deal of distance, but there's still 14 laps for that to change. It's so easy because there's so many fast corners here. One simple mistake can be very, very costly indeed.
So just short notice, when Manu wins this race, if Manu wins this race, he will have the championship in the bag.
That he will. He has to have, by the end of the feature race, he has to have at least a 2-point advantage over Fizzy to claim the championship definitively. Still a long way to go, though. Let's see what happens. AJ4, Gibbs is up to 5th position now. Flying K-Man is 6th. Dokeman 7. Mr. DBZ Leica has gained 2 positions in 8th place. Paradiski in the top 10 now. Mr. Alcon, first race out for that I've seen him in. I think he tried to take part in last week's race but was unable to do so. El Nano has dropped to 11th. Warm Tire still running in 12th position. Jump up to the front then. Manu coming through the final turn. Fizzy still holding off Pedro. That's a fight that's going to take quite a long time to resolve, I suspect. Through a Rouge. Up onto the Camel Straight again. Pedro in the slipstream, he's really not going to be able to do anything because they're pretty much at top speed before they start the Camel Straight, let alone going to be able to do anything whilst they're in that straight itself. AJ looks on in fourth. Manu beginning to stretch his legs now at the front of the field. This is going to be about tire management and patience, I think.
Yes, more definitely. Tires will play a big role here in Spa, especially in the middle sector where the grip is very, very important.
Absolutely. Now, Fizzy has done very, very well throughout the whole season at managing his tires. Looks like either Pedro had a bit of a mistake somewhere. I think he might have done. Oh, Fizzy just had a brilliant run through that middle sector there because he's really got himself a bit of breathing space from Pedro now.
Well, that's the thing I see here. Fizzy is closing in on today at this point in the race. Today also, some people in the chat may know that he's also on his old Logitech G25 tonight, as his T300 broke down, it is broken and he has to order a new one which didn't arrive in time, so he's on the G25, probably costing him some tenths of his race pace.
And he's that good that he's still leading the race by a relatively comfortable position. Anyone watching my stream would have noticed I just got joined by one of my cats. One of my cats pestering me, as they tend to do. Down the start finish mate once more. Manu still leads from Fizzy. Pedro, AJ, Gibbs running pretty well in fifth position now as distance fore and aft. Stokeman 6, where's K-Man gone? DBZ Leica, K-Man's fallen down to 8th position. He's come to grief at some point. Mr. Alcon's already coming past Paradiski, so Paradiski's had trouble. Mr. Alcon comes up to 9th place with... Oh, just as I say that,
oh.
Mr. Alcon has spun at the top of Orish, yeah, and clunks into the barrier. He's still going, but no doubt has got some damage from that particular impact.
He had luck, though, that he didn't crash completely and into the barrier, just clipped it with the front wing, but that's definitely some kilometers per hour lost on the straights.
I think Paradisi's got some damage as well, or my game is showing him turning partly sideways, so I think he may have some damage sustained earlier on this race. Back up to the front then. Manu. AJ. Fizzy. Staring at the back of that red Denverville car yet again. I reckon he could probably draw it from memory. It probably haunts him in his sleep by now.
Well, we don't see many fights here at the moment. I think that's partly because usually you have some nice fights in Spa because of the long straights, but if everyone is...
Oh, Manu's had a problem! Manu's had a slight... it was a half spin, really, at the bus stop chicane. Apologies for cutting you off there, Tony. Wow. But because of that, Fitty is now closed right in on him.
Yes. It's less than a second of a gap now at the moment, so, wow. Will we see some nice fight here, as I was just saying that there are no fights?
I think Manu may have inadvertently created one. So you just got a little bit sideways in the bus stop chicane, and Fizzy's right with Manu now. Exactly on the back of what you were saying there, Tony. Because the setup's a default, everyone's running the same setup, and the circuit's very quick. So because all the setups are exactly the same, there's no room for people to experiment with different setups, so everyone's pretty much going to top out at roughly the same kind of point.
Yeah. That's true.
But here we go again. Fizzy on Manu. God, Fizzy is determined to get that win, and why on earth not?
He wants to maintain his chances to win the championship. That's understandable.
Absolutely, absolutely. They come through, pull on again. Down through 12 and 13. Manu's run wide! Manu has run wide on the exit of that chicane, but just about got away with it as the braking zone for the next turn was very close indeed. That's actually bringing Pedro into the mixture as well.
Mm-hmm.
And back down towards the bus stop again.
Wow. That pressure on today at the moment. Ooh.
Especially if Manu's using a steering wheel he's not quite so comfortable with. This could play into Fizzy's favour. Manu having to take a very defensive line on the entrance of that chicane there. Fizzy is going to be leaning on him as much as possible. AJ's still there. Gibbs is still in fifth position as well. I just saw at the top of the shot.
Oh,
that was close. From that TV angle, that looked very close. Oh, Fizzy having a look on the inside there.
Fizzy seems really, really good on the brakes. Much better than today at this point.
Oh, so close, but there's nothing he's going to be able to do there. But he's trying a different line through Eau Rouge to try and get a run on Manu at the top of Eau Rouge onto the Camel Straight. He's going to have...
They're on same speed.
Manu obviously going to the inside line, they're right side by side. Can Fizzy stay on the inside? Oh, he's got him! Oh my goodness, what an overtake there. But sorry, Tony, I'm talking over you again. What an overtake there at the Le Com.
Yes.
The Manu held the line, and now Pedro's coming into the mixture as well. So if Pedro gets onto Manu's back, he's going to have to defend as opposed to attacking Fizzy.
That was brilliantly executed by Fizzy. He braked later, as I already said, in the corners before he braked later, and he used that to his advantage. Wonderful side-by-side action there.
Absolutely brilliant. Exactly as you said, he had planned that one before he'd even entered the braking zone. He positioned his car perfectly for a late braking. He's beginning to stretch away. Oh, Manu's gone very deep there, and that's given Fizzy a big old breather. Look at the gap that Fizzy's been able to get already.
Wow.
He is a man on a mission today.
Maybe we have to talk about tire wear at this point. Maybe today has stressed his tires too much in the beginning of the race.
It is possible, but also Fizzy could burn his tires out too much. If he pushes too much at this stage, Manu could reel him in. But again, he's got pressure from Pedro behind, and AJ's not far behind either.
Yes.
So whilst Fizzy may be running away with it at the moment, that could all change very, very quickly. Into the final turn then. Through LeSource. Pedro had an unusual line out of LeSource there.
Looked a little bit slower than today's line.
Indeed, I think that's given Manu a little bit of breathing space. Oh, it looks really bumpy as they come over the top of Eau Rouge there.
It is there, it is.
Have you been to Spa yourself?
Not in real life, no. Unfortunately not.
No, nor I. Nor I. I would love to do so.
And I will definitely do it at some point in my life, but...
Spa, Silverstone and Monaco are probably races I would love to actually go and see live.
Yeah, and Le Mans and Nordschleife, of course.
The problem with Nordschleife is you can't see much of... Oh, Manu's getting a bit out of shape again.
Oh, yeah.
Nordschleife is a wonderful track, but you can only see a tiny... Considering how big the track is, you can only ever see a tiny part of it.
That's true. But Manu, you can drive it yourself, so that's a big plus.
Very true. Very true indeed. I think Manu is definitely not as comfortable in this race as we've seen previously. Is that entirely down to the wheel? Is that down to the track? Who knows?
Or a combination? The pressure in the championship?
Could well be. Could well be. I mean, Fizzy really is stretching his legs now at the front. He's got, a couple of seconds or so?
Mm-hmm.
Your overlay is probably working, as I never got around to speak getting hold of you to get my overlay working.
That.
Yeah, I just never had a moment to sit down with you and get that sorted.
Yeah, so yeah, it says that we are at about 4 seconds, 3-4 seconds advantage now for Fizzy, so he's probably through if he doesn't screw up anything.
Still 9 laps to go. Well, we're coming to the end of this lap, so there'll be 8 laps to go then. Pedro's still breathing down Manu's neck now.
Pedro a little bit wide in La Source again, but it didn't cost him as much time in this lap, so he might be in the position to actually get very, very close to that.
He has a good to run through a Rouge.
On the camel straight, yeah.
And again, they're going to top up really early. So Manu's gone defensive already. And then jumped straight back in front of Pedro. He might well have thought twice about that defensive move, but that's exactly how Fizzy managed to nail him. But then that's a bit of a no-win. If he takes a more wider line, then Pedro's going to throw one up the inside.
Mm-hmm. Again, on the brakes, I think Manu has problems on the brakes. He's always losing some meters, some tenths on the brake.
Pedro's still waiting with him. AJ's not far behind. Just going to have a look down the field now. Gibbs is rather on his own in fifth position. DBZ Leica has got Flying Cayman right on his gearbox. So we have a battle here for sixth position as well. Flying Cayman is sizing up with DBZ Leica at 8, I think that is. Rivage. And Paradiski is looming in eighth position right behind those pair. To make that a battling trio. Stokeman holding 9 with Mr. Alcon in 10th position. Oh, was there impact? Was there impact? Did you hear that as well? DBZ Leica, so jumping up, where is he?
Something happened. I only saw that he lost 2 positions and now he's off again.
He's lost the front wing. He may well be pulling off to retire. Oh no, he's still going. I just saw he's lost his front wing. Oh yeah. My goodness me, he's got horrific damage.
I think that
damage.
Car is done for.
It could well be, because that car does not want to go in a straight line, but he's going to limp back to the pit anyway. He's not got too far to go before he gets back to the pit. He's down in 10th position and likely to lose 11th. El Nano is just come through Lacon Malmedy, I think. So he's quite some way away. So, Mr. DBZ Leica spun again. Trying to get a very, very sick car back to the pits. And
why is Pedro in the pits?
Why is Pedro in the pit indeed? What's happened to him?
We must have missed that. Something happened to Pedro, but we don't know.
Yeah, whilst concentrating on this DBZ Leica, why on earth is that pit exit so slow? I've had that one driving this second before.
It's terrible.
It's ridiculous. But Audi comes, he's done his 7th position now.
Well, one thing is that takes out pressure from today.
It does indeed.
Since it is mid-race, I can only imagine that Pedro went for a tire change maybe, but you lose so much time, especially here in Spa with the very slow pit exit. Can't really imagine that was part of his strategy.
But AJ's really not far behind either, so that's handed the last podium position to him. And he's looking pretty solid and consistent, so he may well be able to put some pressure on Manu later on in the race. But Fizzy, wow, if I just bring up my map overlay and show that as Fizzy starts to go through, turn 17, I think.
Paradiski had a little spin there in the mid sector.
Paradisi was down in 8th or 9th, or so, although, oh no, 7th, beg your pardon, he was elevated because of DBZ Leica's misgivings, so he's still 7. Blind Cam has lost some time, I think, somewhere, or he's lost an opponent, because he's now on his own. Pedro is in 5th position, charging on. Gibbs is obviously elevated to 4th. What's the gaps now? It's... The Manu has got some breathing space. He still has Fizzy in sight, but we will see. It's still 6 laps to go. There's still a fair distance on this track, but we are closer to the end of the race now, so we're in the final third of the race, essentially.
And our biggest mover so far is Gibbs with plus 4 positions.
It's surprising that the biggest mover is actually such a small position change.
To be expected, something happened to Pedro again.
Well, again?
He only lost position.
Flying K-Man, yes. So Flying K-Man has taken 5th position now, so Pedro, I guess, has had a spin somewhere. But he's now going to have to chase the South African down once more.
Must have been in the bus stop, I think.
Could well be. Unfortunately, I didn't see. I'm going to leave the top three alone, as they're fairly well spaced out at the moment. Gibbs is completely on his own in 4th. Flying K-Man, as previously mentioned, in 5th with a charging Pedro behind him. Whoa, hello. We've got Paradisi and Stokeman having their own battle as they came onto the Kemmel Strait. Paradisi is in trouble, I think. He's suddenly very slow. He's losing ground all the time. Has he got another problem?
It might be very well, but at the moment it looks like he's... He loses some pace, I think. He loses some pace.
He's definitely got a problem of some kind. Stokeman has flown past him and has run off, and now we see Mr. Alcon all over him.
Oh, and a little nudge from behind.
Give him a nudge. So Mr. Alcon actually waited for Paradisi to get back onto track, but Paradisi's in all sorts of trouble. And then Mr. Alcon's gotten past him and literally just left him for dead. So I'm assuming Paradisi's going to be coming into the pits at his next opportunity. El Nano now back into the top 10 again.
And Pedro is chasing down Flying Cayman. He is very, very close at the moment, so he probably tries to overtake him in the next few corners.
Oh, and Mr. DBZ Leica has spun at the bus stop chicane. So as you were just mentioning that, I was just looking at DBZ Leica, and he's decided to pirouette, giving 11th place to Franco Droz. And that is it. So we have 12 runners still going then.
Cayman and Pedro, very fair, leaving very much room there, maybe too much room for each other, but now Pedro is by
Pedro's
anyway.
Pedro's claiming that inside line very much for himself. Oh, Flying Cam is not letting that one go, but...
Ooh, no anti-spins!
I think he was a little bit too eager to get back into the slipstream there, it looked like, and has lost 6th position now to Stokeman. Stokeman's very steadily making his way through the field as we are now in the final 5 laps of this race. Pedro now has got quite a bit of gap at 4 and aft. Gibbs, AJ still holding 3rd. Manu's 2nd, and I think Manu's definitely lost time on Fizzy. I can't even see Fizzy.
Yeah, he seems to be 7 seconds ahead now, and AJ is quite close to today, I have to say.
But still, it's still close enough to make Manu have to think about what he's doing, but still far enough back that he doesn't have to start defending his lines.
Yes. He probably doesn't get too much slipstream at his position at the moment.
I wouldn't imagine so, not from that distance, but this race is definitely Fizzy to lose at this point. And hello to the viewers that have joined my channel. I'm looking at the viewer count. Thank you very much for coming on my side of the camp. As previously mentioned, by all means, check out Tony R's stream as well, Tony R600. We are co-streaming the race today.
And don't forget, KK's channel name is RangerCarrot. RangerCarrot.
I'm surprised no one's asked me. No one has asked me the origins of that name yet.
You want to tell it?
Way back in the day, when I used to subscribe to an English gaming magazine called PC Zone. They used to, when they used to have internet-only games, they used to put dial-up discs, say free subscriptions to AOL for 30 days or something like that, and they'd have a username and password, and they were just two randomly picked names. The username was Ranger, and the password was Carrot. And I read that, I read it, and I thought, yes, I like that combination. I am going to use it, and say I've used it alongside King Kodiak ever since.
That's a good story, but don't use Ranger and Carrot as your credentials now, so everyone would know it.
The man who's still holding second, then AJ's not been able to close the gap a great deal in this last lap and a half whilst we were talking. Fizzy is just streaking away. He can probably afford to just back off the pace a little bit to keep, make sure the tyres will make it to the end.
One thing I definitely noticed from all drivers, they respect the track limits very, very well.
Agreed, yes, we're seeing much more adherence to those kind of things. Gibbs still holding fourth position, again completely on his own. Pedro is in fifth position, he hasn't got any company where he is. Bergman, he too is completely on his own. Oh no, I beg your pardon. Oh, is that? That's a back marker that's getting out of the way. I think that's Paradiski that was getting out of the way. I thought Stokeman had someone chasing him there, but he was in fact Paradiski getting out of the way. K-Man can see Stokeman just about, but is still quite a way back from here. Mr. Alcon holding 8th position. Again, he's on. Everyone is pretty much on their own. Paradiski was just seen being lapped by the front runners. Nel Nano. Towards the beginning of the lap, that is through. It's coming up to Puan, I think. Bring up the map, find out where he is. Yes, that's coming up to Puan. DBZ Likers just. Which line is he crossing? That's the old line, so he's got. He's also got Pedro right behind him, so. Oh, well done, Mr. DBZ Likers, jumping out of the way of Pedro there to not hold him up any further. And Franco Droz. My camera got a little bit lost there. But Franco Droz just coming down the old start finish line. to see. Oh, that was really bizarre.
And yeah, DBZ Liker spinning on the green carpet on the exit of Rouge there.
Okay, so he's just spinning himself around. Franco Droz is just going to come past him at this point. Possibly not. No, not quite. He manages to retain 11th position. That Manu that's just gone past him, I assume. Back up to the front then, Fizzy just coming up to, yep, he's just coming through the final turn, 17 before the bus stop. Manu, he's beginning to lose AJ now, but if he's going to mount a charge, he's not got long to do it in. Who's got the fastest lap? I'm assuming that's Manu, but no, it's not. It is Fizzy, but Pedro's knee very, very close to it as well. Such a shame that he had such trouble, because I think Pedro would have been right in that mixture as well.
I'm almost sure that he could have got today. With his pace, he probably would have overtaken him, but well, that's just speculations, obviously.
So, such is Fizzy's lead that he's gone through Eau Rouge before Manu has started it. But also, such as Manu's gap to AJ, that AJ can only just. Yeah, we only just saw him in some of the camera shots. So the first three are roughly equidistant to one another. So they're just coming to the end. AJ just at the end of the camel straight then. Two laps to go in this feature race, which has most certainly belonged to Fizzy. Beyond any shadow of a doubt. I'm going to have to look up the points tables to see how many points Manu needs to score to secure the championship, or what position Fizzy needs to be, or what the difference between Fizzy and Manu needs to be for Fizzy to get it. I need to look up the points table for that one.
It's 15, so 15 points
for the win.
Yeah, for and Fizzy gets now 25 and today gets 20, so he gets 5 points less. Then he has 12 points advantage.
Well, that leaves a 7 point advantage going in, assuming the position stays as they are. So that'll leave a 7-point advantage to Manu.
We might see an interesting sprint race there.
I think so.
Points are really, really close there.
So Fiti comes around the last turn of La Source to head down the start-finish straight to begin his final lap. Since gaining the lead, he really has been unchallenged in this race, although if you ask Fiti that, he may well have a very different story to tell on that one. On to the camel straight then. That's Paradiski getting out of Manu's way, I just saw in the back of that shot.
That's a bit of a shame that we lost Govant so early.
It is a shame we lost Govac early on.
I think what happened was that he might have crashed into our cars because he didn't set a quali time and started behind us. As I noticed in the qualifying, he didn't set a time for whatever reason. Maybe cut track problems or something like that. So, well.
I'm pretty sure someone definitely hit my car before I was able to get out of the way. Unfortunately, is the issue that Project Cars presents us as commentators. Yep. We have no choice but to start on the grid, and if no one sets a time, they end up starting behind us.
Definitely, it's a shame, but nothing we can do about that at the moment.
Sadly not, but here we have Fizzy then coming around Stavolo. Down towards through 16, coming around turn 17 now. Down towards the bus stop once more. Here, someone buzzing around, not sure who that is. That's El Nano. That's El Nano's directly ahead of Fizzy. I thought we'd lost Manu for a moment there. Oh, my camera's gone a bit bananas. No, Fizzy, not that line. It looked like Fizzy might have started to celebrate a tad early then.
Wrong line.
Wrong style line. But here he comes then. Your FITA race winner for this round is everyone's favourite commentator, Fizzy!
Fizzy, woo! And what a today race behind him in P2. There he is.
Manu comes across the line to take second position. And AJ, brilliant podium for me. It's a shame we've missed AJ for a good half of this season because he's had some really great races the last few. Here comes Gibbs! Gibbs! Gibbs has finished a race in the points, in decent points as well. Oh, great job for you. So it's a shame I couldn't really look much more of what you were doing, but everyone was so spaced out. and I don't mean in a drug sense. At that race, there wasn't a lot of battling going on. Paradis is listing fifth, that's because he is lap. But here comes Pedro to claim that fifth position. It's a shame, it's such a shame he had to go through the pits. But, oh, was he to claim the fastest lap at the end? He has as well. Pedro has pinched the fastest lap from Fizzy. I don't think Fizzy will care a great deal. Pedro has claimed the fastest lap on his run at the end there. That's Flying Cayman just coming down the line now. He's going to claim 7th position, I think. Oh, Stokeman. Beg your pardon. Stokeman's claimed 6th. So, yes, Flying Cayman is 7th. That's why I'd lost a position here. And here comes Mr. Alcon. In the first race that I've been able to commentate on him, he's going to claim 8th. Here he comes. Here we go. There's 8th position to him. And El Nano, I believe, is still running. I think El Nano was the last of the non-lapped runners. He comes down to the bus stop. I think, yeah, he's pretty much the last non-lapped runner. Old Mr. Deepset Leica, beg your pardon, I forgot about you. Whoops, looks like El Nano was a tad wide on the exit of bus stop there. He comes down to La Source to finish his race off in 9th place. Gently puts the power on. Down he comes to finish his race. There he is in 9th. So I believe I'm having Mr. Paradisi appear in two different places. Oh, Franco Droz is in that mixture somewhere. Which is the way that the interface gets a little bit confused when it comes to lap runners. It puts lap runners in place of the non-lap runners as far as position is concerned. So it makes the position count all completely cocked until everyone has crossed the line. I think everybody has now. Looking at, I'm just watching Mr. Deepzer Leica. I thought he might have still been running, but he's very slow now. So there we go. That concludes your feature race round number 15. That's a Fizzy being your feature race winner with Manu in second and AJ rounding up your position, podium positions, if I can get my words out. Gibbs 4, Pedro 5, Stokeman 6, Flying Cayman 7, Mr. Alcon 8, El Nano 9, and Paradiski are your top 10 for this race. So this will be coming to an end in 110 seconds time.
So a little waiting time where we can get excited for the next qualifying and for the sprint race.
Now I'm going to take this opportunity to finish my dinner off. It is now cold, but I don't care. I'm hungry. So then, people in chat on either side, on either mine or Tony's, please, any questions you have, any comments to give us, by all means, fire away.
Yes. Now's the time to answer all the questions that you might have. So just tell them right away.
I have a question for you, Mr. Tony.
Oh my god.
When did you get into sim racing?
When did I get into sim racing? That's a good question, actually. And even if I'm only 25 years old, I'm doing that for so long that I don't really remember. I think, well, racing games... I started racing games with Grand Prix 2 because my parents bought me Geoff Crammond's Grand Prix 2 back in 95, I think.
I started with Geoff Crammond's Grand Prix 1.
Oh, we had that in school on the computers. That was, the graphics of that were so ridiculous.
I mean, they were good for the time, but yeah, you look back at it now, you're like,
yeah. But yeah, actually, my first real sim, I would say, was R-Factor 1.
Mm-hmm.
So R-Factor 1 and GDR 2, that's about... in the beginning of the 2000s, I would say, and that's where I really got into sim racing, when I was like 12, 13 years old, I think.
Also, to put this in perspective, you're 25 now, I'm 36 now, so I have 11 years more gaming experience. On, well, not quite, I wasn't gaming when I was born, although given the times, I probably would have done. Yes, I remember spending a lot of time on Grand Prix 1.
Oh, and Gibbs is in the chat. Woo, P4, he says.
And Franco Droz has also said first points. People are leaving the session, so it doesn't look like the session is going to end of his own accord. Jump out of that.
Yes, Season 2 has to be planned. That was the question from Lawrence, but as Gibbs is in the chat, he's the best man to ask that question. It has yet to be planned, so...
But I think the popularity of the league is definitely there to plan it. I believe they're also thinking, depending on how many signups there are, to have a multiple-tiered system, same as the GT races are done.
Mm-hmm.
But those, of course, dependent on how many signups there are. So if you're interested, head down to apexracing.com. Have a look around the forums and sign up and get involved. And then you'll have idiots like me talking about you.
Today's ace in the chat, boring race. Sorry, guys. Well, that one fight with Fizzy wasn't that boring, I think. And the start actually wasn't boring as well.
All boils down to the sprint race, then. Has the lobby come back up yet? Don't know is the answer to that. Of course, it's not going to change track, so I don't know if it's actually been rehosted. Do you know if it's actually gone down and come back up again?
Gibbs is in a lobby, so he might have created another one. Or who was the host in the last? AJ was the host.
AJ,
right?
Was the host, yeah.
So let me see where AJ is. AJ.
Fizzy's the new lobby host, so if you can rejoin us.
Yeah, AJ is actually not in the lobby yet, so.
Here we go. It's just relaunching now.
Okay.
So head back in. Apologies for the straw noise there. Yeah, man, I didn't get into, I've never been into competitive sim racing myself. Not in this guise. I've always been quite a fan of, like how I do time trialing, like every, doing a lap in every car on every track. Obviously, I'll never do that because there's over 10,000, 12,000 combinations or something like that. So I'd never achieve it. Certainly not before Project Cars 2 comes out.
Yeah. Well, if we're talking about professional sim racing online, I think I started in 2012, actually, with Project Cars, actually. Before, I only did, like, random races and a little bit here and there, but the TGC community, the Gentleman's Club, which was one of the first more professional communities for Project Cars 1 during the Alpha, this is where I started with a GT3 league there.
Oh, okay.
And the server is up again.
Mm-hmm. Server is up, and we have 14, including myself, currently in there.
So yes, Manu needs 3 more points to secure the championship, which will be, let me see, 3
not
points.
7th that he needs, or something like that.
3 points is 8. 8th place. 8th place.
So as long as Manu finishes 8th or higher, he will secure on the basis of the he has had. Even if he gets in 8th place and Fizzy wins, they will draw on points, but I believe, because Manu has more race wins,
yes,
then the championship would go to him.
Correct. But first, Fizzy has to win the race, obviously.
Indeed, yes. I bet you this is going to be the most cautious start that we see from Manu.
Definitely.
However, we are not in the qualifying session just yet. We're waiting for people to join us. We have. Are you back with us, Mr. Tony?
Yes,
yes, you are.
I'm back in the lobby.
Oh, you have my pit spot second place, I see. That's usually where the server puts me for some really weird reason. So, still waiting for people to rejoin us. And seeing what.
Oh, yeah.
What.
We forgot that. That there is a point for the pole position, I think.
Oh, yes, so
and
there
Andy,
is.
Andy in the chat just told me, or told us.
Yes, thank you for that reminder. So, you're quite right, there is.
Busy already got a point for the pole position in the previous race. So
he gained 26 points last race, yeah?
It's 7th place Manu would need for that already. And if Fizzy gets pole again, Manu would need the 6th place.
So that will be Manu's target, particularly if Manu's a little bit off pace because of the steering wheel problem, then 6th has to be his target. Will he do a Schumacher and or a Senna and punt Fizzy off in the first corner? I certainly hope not. So then, not really a great deal we can mention at the moment, as we are not yet underway with the qualifying session. So
nope.
Do bear with us, listeners and watchers. We will get underway when the server switches over to the qualifying session, when everyone has rejoined us.
Good. So my stream had some hiccups, but it's running again. Thanks for telling me, nevertheless. And the qualifying is starting. 10 minutes qualifying starting now for the sprint race.
So 14 cars will be taking to the track then. Line K-Man is leaving the... I imagine everyone's going to stream out. Why on earth? I'm watching Flying K-Man go through the pit exit, and it is... You could walk quicker.
Yes.
It's ridiculous.
It's completely ridiculous. I think the pit stop time with tire change is one of the longest of all tracks here at Spa. It's like something like 42 seconds.
Absolutely, man. There's whoops, and someone spun on the after a route already. I'm not sure who that was. That's Ryan Kamen of Warming Up says. I'm going to pick up who that is. It's at the front of the pack. Oh, it's Mr. Alcon, who has also spun and is bouncing over the curbs. Oh, that was a very abrupt re-entry there. So that's
many people having some problems in the warm-up lap here.
And Mr. Alcon has let through Flying Cayman and Manu. And Pedro, I assume that is. Jump back up through. Flying Cayman that's let Manu through.
Yes, for a moment I thought those two guys want to do some slipstreaming in the qualifying. But Manu is now off and away, so Cayman won't have much of his slipstream, I guess.
No, I think you'll have a hard time keeping up with Manu. Nothing, not that wasn't meant in a derogatory sense against Cayman, but Manu is, as we've seen time and again, is just such an incredible driver in this car. Comes down towards turn 17. Pedro's left the session for some reason.
Maybe he has some problems with his wheel or something, some connection problems, which happens quite often.
Could be.
Hopefully he can drive a lap in the qualifying. But when he's entering the lobby later than us, he will be in front of us anyway, so no problem.
Mm-hmm.
So, first timed lap for today starting now.
So over he goes then, down to a Rouge. Nams.
Where's our friend Fizzy? Oh, he is in the middle sector. I'm not sure if he's already on his timed lap, but...
I don't think so, because Manu was Manu was the first man to cross the line, I believe.
Yes.
I've lost him. Where is he? There he is. Oops. I'm getting my cameras all completely wrong now.
Manu's first sector time doesn't look too well. He was like 2/10 or 3/10 faster in the first qualifying.
He's still struggling then. Still struggling to get to grips then with the wheel or the setup or this track. Any combination of the above. Through down to turn 12. Through Stavolo. Turn 17. My cats decided to join me on my desk again.
That's nice from them.
Only because I have food next to me. It's the only reason he's here. So into the bus stop then.
That reminds me of the Nürburgring 24-hour race we did with F1 Massa, where his cat sneaked into the room. Or snuck into the room and, then made some noise and stuff, and he was actually driving the 24-hour race at this point, so that was not the best thing.
Oh, no. There goes Manu crossing the line then, so it's like 157.435, that's not far off.
Not far off, but could be better.
Could be better, it's not far off what his best lap was in the feature race either. So coming up to the halfway point in the quali then. We've seen some times on the board. AJ currently second. 158.112. Paradiski, Flying Cayman, and Mr. Alcon have set a lap. Whoa! That's Manu losing it at Lecom. Doing a perfect pirouette and parking it at the double Lecom. Just about got enough time to come out and do a flying lap, as we have seen. There's Flying Cayman also coming out of the pits.
Mm-hmm. He's lucky that he still has 4 minutes, so he can drive one more timed lap. But that's an advantage for Fizzy, obviously.
I think so, because Fizzy will have enough time to finish the one he's on and do another. So AJ is... where is he? He's just coming down to Puan. Currently second with a 158.112.
Fizzy entering La Source and going over the line any second now. So let's see what his time will be. I Here think he's on a very fast lap. Yes.
Oh, 156.892. Excellent. I think only him and Pedro with the only two times under 157, I believe, in the feature race. Oh, that was close.
that was really, really close.
I think it was Mr. DBZ Leica having to jump out of the way there. Fizzy takes quite a wide line in on the entry of that chicane. I think if that is Mr. DBZ Leica, he's gone wide at Lecom.
It's something I often see with those Formula cars, and it's not a style I like to drive myself. So I'm much slower in the Formula car, so I guess it's the faster style to drive around those cars.
So in the GT cars, you stick closely to the apexes, I assume.
If you go that wide in a GT car, you probably get understeering and just don't make
the
corner.
You'll
at
never
all.
Make the apex. I see. So Fizzy then just coming through turns 12 and 13. Round Stavolo. Through 16. Round 17. We'll be around 17 in a second. There he comes. And here there's someone in front of him. Let's change cameras. Oh, he's backed off. Fizzy has backed off. So you can see that is that AJ, I think, possibly in front of him? Yeah, that's AJ that's in front of him. So Fizzy decided to back out of that one and give him, he's just about got enough time to do so, as long as he crosses the line in the next 30 seconds. That would be awkward if Fizzy has actually given up too much time. I don't think he has.
No, he calculated that correctly, I think.
I think so. It left him very little time on the table, though. So through Le Source, then. He comes to start his last flying lap. Yeah, it's just under 10 seconds spare there.
But that enables him to get the last shot of the qualifying, definitely, because after him, people won't make a full lap anymore.
Absolutely. So Manu, I believe, would imagine he is on a flying lap. He's still second on 157.435. He is just coming through Rivage, I think. So he's just coming down to Puan now.
Oh, and he spins.
Wow, that just completely... I've never seen Manu spin like that.
That's the pressure on the shoulders.
Well, the damage he's going to have to that car, he's not going to have enough time to do anything about it. I'm surprised he's not just decided to jump back to the pits, but
no.
He is staying off the, staying out of the way of the racing line. Oh, okay, he's decided to write his name in the wall with the nose of his car.
Oh, there was Fizzy behind. Or maybe he wanted to disturb him a little bit.
I did think that. I thought, is he going to jump in his way and go, boo? But yeah. I think he thought better of it. He's staying out of the way. Oops, he got in El Nano's way there. He's lost the front wing as well. Is he going to park up now? Yeah, there he goes. Into the pits then. Where is Fizzy? Let's jump to him.
Oh. So,
pole is definitely going to go to Fizzy unless AJ pulls a blinder out of nowhere, but no. He's not far enough in the lap.
He can't.
So pole then.
So that's another point for Fizzy.
That it is. So
and that means today needs sixth place.
So let's just see if Fizzy does improve on the time he has set. Currently 156.892 round La Source for the final time. Down he comes. Couldn't see who that was in front of him. I backed out of it. I was hoping he might have improved on the time, but never mind. Fizzy then is your pole sitter for the sprint race.
Awesome job. Awesome job he has done with all those qualifyings in this season. You have to say that.
Absolutely. So your order for the sprint race is Fizzy, Manu, AJ, Worn Tire, Stokeman, Gibbs, Paradiski, Flying came in, Mr. Alcon, and L Nano are your top 10.
Oh, it looks like DB said Liker starts behind me or something.
Oh, lovely. So we have someone to jump out of the way of.
Mm-hmm.
There we go. There is Fizzy and L. Oh, and there's no one behind me.
Oh, yeah, wonderful. We are on the correct.
Oh, no, Mr. DJ Liker is behind you because you're 2 seconds ahead of me. But he's got a clear run behind you, so I am out of the way, so it gets spectator spot up to the front then, and Fizzy has held the lead as he goes into, oh my goodness, but Manu is right on top of him, as you can imagine, through Eau Rouge. On to the Wenita straight already, and Manu's going onto the outside line. Does he have the pace to get the lead up from Fizzy? Fizzy's got the inside line on the beginning of the part of the chicane Lacombe. Manu's just mentioned nose ahead.
Yeah.
Oh, and Fizzy spun, and he's been hit. Fizzy has come to grief already. He has fallen through the. Oh, there's another impact, I think. Yep, that was Mr. Alcon, I think, coming to grief. Oh, goodness me. So this has become Manny's race to lose. So, eight lap sprint race, and Manu is running away with it. It's Gibbs up to second position now. That's Worn Tire. I think Worn Tire was who nudged Fizzy there. It looked like it was the Panasonic livery that hit our own Fizzy. Goodness me.
I think Fizzy lost it going side by side with today, probably on the entry of Lecombe, and then Worn Tire had nowhere to go.
Absolutely, absolutely. Looks like Worn Tire hasn't suffered any damage though, as he's sticking with Gibbs for second, battle for second place with El Nano in fourth position, holding off Flying Cayman. So quite a juggle. There's Govac in sixth position. So we have quite a different collection of drivers in that top six. And Paradiski is in seven. Mr. Divas at Leica is fending off Mr. Alcon for eighth place, and that is Fizzy in 10. Oh, that's Mr. DBZ Liker going a little bit wide there after turn 17 as they come down into the bus stop for the first time in the sprint race, and there's impact as well. Oh, it's El Nano and Paradiski. El Nano and Paradiski have come to grief, and that's someone else has come to grief as well. El Nano is being pushed by Paradiski. That's quite a... Okay, and that was Seri. Seri, I think, is also coming to grief as Mr. Alcon enters the pits. But Fizzy has jumped up to 7th position because of all that misgivings, and he's right on the tail of Mr. DBZ Leica.
Yes, he is P7, and also Govand got up to P4 due to this rumble there in the last part of the last lap.
So DBZ Leica is fending off Fizzy. Fizzy looks like he's going to go to the inside line. As they come down the Wellington straight, Fizzy has got the inside line for the beginning of Lacombe. He has DBZ Leica holding on. Oh, and there's impact. Mr. DBZ Leica did not get a great run through Lecombe. Fizzy has decided to hold station for another corner, but he has done. He's now on the outside. Oh, did DBZ Leica let him through?
Going around the outside.
Goodness me, either DBZ Leica's got damage and let him through. Oh, that was a great overtaking maneuver by Fizzy there, as he is now up to 6th position. Flying Cayman holding in fourth position now. Oh, it was Worn Tire. I thought I'd lost someone. Worn Tire has come to grief. He's clearly had some damages. He's staying right on the outside of the track, and he's not going straight at all. So Worn Tire's had a terrible race here at Spa. So another position up for Fizzy. Cayman 4, Govac 3, Gibbs holding second with Manu still holding the lead. At this point in time, pretty unchallenged at the front. Gibbs is probably enjoying the fact that he's in second.
And he will pretty much enjoy that, definitely.
And not parked in a gravel trap somewhere. Oh, just as I say that, he spins on the exit of the bus stop. Oh. And Govac has gone through into second place. Commentator's curse yet again.
Again,
I'm going to be really unpopular for that. So many times I just mentioned someone and they spin or come to grief. I'm going to be so unpopular.
Yeah.
So then.
Well, that also means that Govan made up 12 positions in this race. In
wow.
Two laps.
What a stunning start by Govac. Incredible. You can see Manny's got about half the length of the camel straight to himself. as a lead at this stage, as Gomac has already got some distance between him and Gibbs. It was a little bit wide on the exit of Lecom there. Through Malmedy and down to turn 8.
I could imagine that Gowand closes in on Manu quite quickly, as Manu will not be on the utter limit of his car. He will probably drive a little bit slower to maintain his position. He's in no need to go very fast.
Very true, very true. But racing drivers are racing drivers by habit, so they will push no matter what. But there is about a second between the fastest lap of Manu and Govac in Govac's favour. So I imagine that if Govac does manage to close Manu down, he is not going to fight him too much. He does not want to risk that all-important championship.
Something wrong with Fizzy. Fizzy is very, very slow.
Oh, he's... Ah. Yeah, there's cones flying everywhere.
He might have had a cut track penalty, as he was going very wide at Pujol, so he might have been slowed down by the system.
As I jumped to him, and I assume it's DBZ likely, yes it is, there were some of those roadside bollards flying around, so yeah, I think you're right. It looks like Fizzy is back up to pace again, now down in 6th place. Watching K-Man come through the bus stop chicane very, very cautiously. Not surprised, though, as that chicane has caught a number of people out. I have driven that chicane on this track and spun at it many, many times in many, many cars. So K-Man come through. La Source start another lap. Only 5 remaining.
And Govand already on the as of today there.
Yep, I've just jumped up to the same point as they come through Lecom, through Malmedy. Will Manu fight Govac and hang on to the leader? I shouldn't imagine he will, but...
He won't, definitely not.
If he doesn't, he loses out, then see a silly boy. But I mean, where does Fizzy need to finish in order to beat if... Whoa, Govac steady on there. If the worst were to happen and Manu doesn't finish, where would Fizzy have to finish in order to win?
I think it's 10 points advantage. So, or no, what did we say?
He had to finish 6th, so isn't it 6 points?
I think
6 or 7 points Fizzy needs.
Yeah, but the advantage is a little bit more. I think Fizzy needs P3 in that case.
So he needs to be on the podium and for Manu not to score at all, for this to swing in Fizzy's favour. So, of course, at the moment that is not. Oh, Seri's retired. We've got the positions out of whack again. Seri has retired from this race. He's currently showing in the lead, of course, because he jumps to the pits on the lap of which he's retired. So, hence why he appears.
Fizzy lost.
Position. Govac spun! Govac has spun! Again, the bus stop chicane catching out another driver. So Govac gave it too much gas on the exit of the bus stop and spun. That's going to give Gibbs an opportunity to get back on his gearbox again, and indeed it does. So we have Manu to run off a little bit into the distance, but not too far. 4 laps to go.
And I just watched Fizzy overtaking DBZ Liker. It seems like Fizzy loses some kilometers per hour on the straight, so he probably has some damage.
I would imagine so. I mean, he did hit the wall at Lecom on the first lap, so it wouldn't surprise me if he has lost some pace there. Gibbs is staying on the gearbox of Govac quite well here as they come through Malmedy and down to Rivage again. Oh, Govac's gone slightly wide on the entrance of Rivage there.
He's pretty much on the edge with his car at the moment, I think.
Oh, he's got another little issue. Oh, he's run wide there on the exit of turn 9. Down to Pujol again. Oh, steady. Nearly ran a bit wide there. He's got a... Goodness me, he's really giving it all he's got. Gibbs has not had a great run through that section. He's lost quite a bit of time on Govac. Govac reeling Manu in again. Oh, he's run wide again as Govac. He's only just held on to that. So again, that brings Gibbs right back into play again.
What is today doing?
What is Manu doing? He may, I think he's let go back and probably gives through on the exactly as we were saying before. He does not have to have that race win. He's decided to let them go.
But that looked really, really strange.
It did look really odd. He was moving around. I can't believe he's lost heat in his tyres.
No.
But Manu down to third now. He doesn't, as what he said, he does not have to have that win. So go back in the lead with Gibbs holding second. That is the best run we've seen from Gibbs all year. All year, all season.
Well, to be honest, Gowan is going off track, not by accident, I have to say. He's just cutting all the corners and now he spins again.
Oh, goodness me. Where did he go? Oh, he's clouted the wall very, very hard. That could be the end of Govac's race. Oh, yep, that's the end of Govac's race. Yeah, he has retired. He's put himself straight into the... And Manu's overtaking Gibbs.
Yeah, I didn't understand that either. I think Gibbs slowed down too much when he saw Govac crashing.
Could be. Govac just suddenly vanished from my picture. Didn't actually manage to pick him up at all, but pushed too much at Eau Rouge and is out as a result. So Manu but back in the lead.
Maybe it was a wise decision from today to give the room to Govan there.
Given the lead and yeah, absolutely. And as a result, Gibbs seems very, very slow suddenly. So did he pick up damage as a result of... I didn't see an impact between Gibbs and Govac.
I didn't see any either. Well, I can only imagine that he might have avoided the wreck and wrecked himself or something like that, because I didn't see his car at all in the scene.
No, it could well have had an impact. Maybe he's so high up the order he's getting a nosebleed. Who knows? Fizzy is back up to third, though, however, due to various retirements. And so that is, of course, the position he would need if Manu were not to score. But that is seeming rather unlikely at this stage. But there's still three laps to go, or two and a half laps to go. You never know what's going to happen. We don't have we really don't have very many guys running at all, do we? Gives a spun.
On the exit of the bus stop.
Oh, no. We only have 9 cars running. There's only actually 11 in the server, including us.
Mm-hmm.
So there's only 9 cars still running in this race.
Many DNFs. Well, I told before, the sprint race has only 8 laps, so people are pushing it to the limits, especially because it's the last race of
the
season.
It's the final race of the season, yeah, absolutely. So 2 laps left then. Manu is on the Camel Straight. Completely under... Oh, there's Gibbs just started the Camel Straight as... Manu gets off of it, so Manu really has just got to take it easy for the next lap and 3/4 to bring that home for the title. The tele racing driver just slowed down, and it really is, that's like telling a person not to breathe. But at the moment there doesn't appear to be any particular battles going on. Just looking at the map, Everyone is pretty much on their own.
AJ and Paradiski seem to battle.
Let's have a look there. Oh, beg your pardon, sir, there are. Paradiski having a look on the inside there, but at Lecom, but to
why,
no
why is
avail.
AJ so much down the order anyway? I think he was quite fast. Oh no, it says +3, so he started from P9, so he messed up the qualifying this time probably.
He's not a very good racer. I mean, his best lap so far has been a 2:09.31.
Strange.
We saw AJ running in the top 4 early on in the feature race, so he's not had a great race this time out.
Might have some damage as well.
Could well be. I mean, we did see some impact, as we invariably do, in the first turns of the first lap, so it could have been he came to grief early on.
Mm-hmm.
But he's got himself a bit of gap
also,
to Paradiski.
I'm missing Pedro as well, so... Well, many of the favorites are not running anymore, or very slow, damaged probably.
So Manu, on his own then, begins his final lap of the sprint race. And we don't even see Gibbs in the same shot as Manu. We look at Gibbs, he's just started his last lap, and then Fizzy just doing so now as well.
Yeah.
So Fizzy can see Gibbs is probably not going to push too hard to try and catch him, but who knows. It's going to take a mistake from Gibbs for that to become a battle later on. Just a good half of the Kemmel straight gap between Fizzy and Gibbs, and back to Flying Cayman. Flying Cayman's a pretty solid race.
Yeah,
both today, both this race and the feature race. So
I think his whole season wasn't that bad. He had some spins and some moments here and there, but actually he scored points every time he could. And well, they will probably win the team championship as well with Manu. And
I would imagine so. Yes, he's been getting Flying Cayman has been steadily improving as the season's gone on as well.
Mm-hmm, definitely.
It's always good to see. Is my nameplates are getting it all wrong. Where is Manu? He is. He's just come through Stavelo. As he is nearing the end of the race for him.
And
through turn
the
16.
Season.
And the season indeed. So round turn 17 then. Oops, running is a little wide there, but he's got that much of a lead. It's really not going to make much of a difference. Down to the bus stop lane for the final time. Don't spin.
Don't spin, don't spin.
He
doesn't spin. He's celebrating early on the wrong start-finish line. I hope he realizes
that. Well, why
that.
Not? I mean, it's pretty much not enough runners left to deny him the championship now. He's pretty much just coasting to the line, and why not? It's been well-deserved. For Manu, he's been right up there the whole season, and this is another win for him. Or is he going to give the win to Gibbs? Let's see what he does. He's
that would be the ultimate
win.
Joke. Yes.
And Gibbs goes through.
Oh.
Gibbs takes his win.
That's funny.
great sportsmanship there from Manu, as he hands the win to Gibbs, your feature race winner then, your sprint race winner rather, here at Spa.
Wonderful.
Is Gibbs. Decent lap as well, 157.790. Manu in second, taking the championship title. Mm-hmm.
And
Fizzy
rounding
out the post. Absolutely deserved, with Fizzy taking it down to the wire, taking it down to the very last race. Fizzy then rounds out your podium positions with Flying Cayman in fourth position. I would imagine, as you say, that does give the team championship to Denbreville. That is Mr. DBZ Leica, who's been fairly consistent in this two rounds. So fifth place for him. AJ, it's a shame he came to grief as he was really running well in the feature race. Comes home in sixth position. Paradiski in seventh, with Mr. Alcon in eighth place. Stokeman, 9. And Tony R is in 10. And I'm 11th.
Yeah, we did very well in this race as well.
No, absolutely. Yeah, I think we capitalized well on retirement. Well then, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for joining us. I'm going to be bringing my stream to an end. Thank you very much for joining us throughout this season. My name is King Kodiak, and I will see you next time for AOR. Yeah. Thank you very much, and goodbye.
Thank you very much for watching, guys, and see you next time.
Good night, good night.